If you're looking for creative ways to share your application data, look no further than this video. I'm going to be breaking down one of the new features from Sofdr, the tabbed layout. This gives you creative new ways that you can share the underlying data in your apps, putting more information on the screen and giving you the capability to share your apps in unique new ways. If learning more about this new amazing feature is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tool suite, and Sofdr is one of those tools that we use religiously. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be breaking down one of the newer features from Sofdr, namely their tabbed layout. This allows you to present data in new creative ways and ultimately fit more on your screen, but doesn't make it feel cramped at all. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to follow along with me inside of Sofdr. Build along right side what you are seeing here on my screen. If you're not already a Sofdr user, please consider using our affiliate link and our special promo code, which I'm sharing on my screen. It will give you over $100 worth of value in Sofdr and some free trial opportunities. Go ahead and plug that in as you see and get signed up for Sofdr today. But without further ado, let's hop on in. Now, I am using a Sofdr template. This is the client portal by Sofdr. And as you can see right here on my screen, we are already synced up with the client portal by Sofdr base. So all of the information that we're going to display here is actually pulling from that Airtable database. If I flip into Airtable, you'll see the database right here. This is all copied as part of the template. If you're new to Sofdr, when you start with a template, in many cases, they will give you the actual underlying database as well. So if you want to make any changes to the way the template performs, you have to start by making changes here in the database. We have users, companies, files, projects, tasks, invoices. I mean, all of the things you might expect inside of a client portal. However, the nice thing about Sofdr is that it gives you this flexibility. If you have your own unique process, which let's face it, many businesses do, you can add it here, but start with adding the proper data structure first and then map it into your front-end application, because that, my friends, at the end of the day, is what Sofdr is. It allows us to display this data selectively in a way that we can control exactly what other people see. We can break it down to exactly the records they see, exactly what they're allowed to edit and delete and add and all of this. That's what Sofdr gives us, is the functionality that we're looking for to really deploy an application to the masses. So now that we're here back inside of Sofdr, let's take a quick look at what the normal homepage looks like in the client portal. You can see I'm scrolling down here that we get the welcome back logged in username. Okay, great. Below that, we see my projects. I'm clicking on this particular block and going over to visibility, and I'm finding that this block for our logged in users who are in the groups of client, employee, or freelancer. So those are three types of users who can access our app. They are the only ones who can see this block that has projects listed out. Now, again, remember, all of this data is being pulled from Airtable. So if I flip into Airtable, we're going to look at our projects over here, and we see that we have these four projects. This is what's being displayed back in the app. So when we look at Sofdr, these four different projects are coming from the Airtable data. Now, we can additionally go into source here and see that the project name is any of the client contact, or the project name has a project member, meaning that the only people who can see this data are people who have been assigned to it. So if you're a team member, you're only seeing projects assigned to you. If you're a client, you're only seeing your projects. Makes sense. If we scroll down, however, we come to find that we have another block here called active projects. What's the difference? Well, if we click on active projects and we look at the right-hand side of the screen, we see that here we don't have any of those user filters. This simply says that the status of these projects is not done, meaning that the project has not been completed. Now, additionally, we click into visibility and we see that this block is only available to admin users. But let's imagine that we had a scenario where we wanted to share this data in two instances. We said, hey, look, we've got this block here that we want to share that's like my projects. But we also want to share on the same page active projects. But we don't want to clutter up a lot of real estate. We don't want our users to log into the app to see this version, have to scroll down, and then see the next block. It's taking up a lot of real estate. It doesn't make a ton of design sense. So instead, let's use tabs. The tabbed layout is going to be perfect for this because we can drop these elements in and allow people to kind of click through really quickly and see exactly what they want to see. But before we do that, let's first turn on our active projects and set the visibility to all of the users. That way, anybody who logs in is going to see this particular block. And we'll do the same for up here. We'll go to the visibility for my projects and we'll set it to include admin as well. So if we preview these changes that we just made, depending on who we are when we log in, we're going to impersonate someone right now. We will see at the top, my projects. Here we're impersonating Lee. These are Lee's projects. And then if we scroll down, we see all active projects. But what if we put them all in the same place with a nice tabbed layout? That's what we want to address right now. So back we go to the back end inside of Studio, and we're going to add a block. Now, when we click here, before we add the actual list block or the whatever block we want to drop in, before we get to that, we go to container. This is very similar to columns, except we're going to have a lot more real estate, as you'll see in just a minute. So I'm going to go with the tab container, and we have two different tabs by default that are available. These are in our settings component of this build. So I'm going to click on tab one, and let's call this My Projects. And let's go ahead and choose an icon here as well to represent this. You can search through all the different options here yourself, but I'm going to go with this little file. And of course, we can also, and this is pretty cool, make the tab conditionally visible. So maybe the only people we want to have access or share access to My Projects are internal users. So we could say, hey, only logged in users who are admin, employee, or freelancer. But clients, forget it. They won't be able to see this tab. This is a pretty cool upgrade because it allows us to keep a lot more information on one page, but we can conditionally hide particular sections of that information. You'll see more when we get to the actual layout component in just a moment. But right now, we're going to say that we're going to move on to tab two. So to access tab two, what we need to do is back on our right-hand panel, go back, and here we can just simply click tab two, and this one will make all projects. And again, we can conditionally set this up. We can apply a different icon if we'd like, and we can even add more tabs if we prefer. We also have the ability to bring in a title and subtitle here. So I could say projects, and if I could spell projects, go here, and more subtext, etc. So you get the idea. We have some flexibility in the display, in the design. We can also go into styles and update the background color, the border, the padding, and then conditionally make this entire tabbed section visible. So bear in mind that you're given more granular control here at the visibility setting level. We can toggle on or off specific visibility for the entire block, and then also for specific tabs. But now that we've set up our tabs, how do we bring data in? Well, we would select the tab that we want to bring the data into, in this case, My Projects, and click here on the plus, then go in and add that element. So in this case, we are looking at our My Projects section down here, which appears to be a grid block. We could bring in a grid element here. Now, in our example, we already have the block built. The My Projects block already exists, and I can more easily just bump it into the container. In order to do that, all I need to do is hover over My Projects here, and there's an icon that says Move Inside Container. Easy enough. We can select the tab container that we want to drop it into, and here we go. Is it going into My Projects tab or the All Projects tab? In this case, My Projects, and boom, just like that, the block was moved into the container. Let's come down to active projects, do the same thing here, move inside container, tab container one, which tab do you want to go to? All projects, and away we go. Now you'll see that we have some other blocks down here. I'm not going to pay any mind to them at this time. I only want to focus on the new tabbed container that's displaying projects. So now we can go back into preview mode. And of course, we're going to impersonate someone again when this loads. Hopefully it's somebody who is internal, because bear in mind, we set conditional visibility to our projects. But here we are impersonating Lee again, and we see my projects automatically loaded up here. But with a simple toggle, we just click on that tab, we get a view of all projects. So this is exactly how we are getting more information on a smaller amount of real estate and making it super simple for people to click through. So I love the new tabbed containers, and I'm sure you will find a number of different ways to insert them into your existing apps and maybe even some new apps and get additional functionality from them. I know we went pretty quickly in this video, but I hope you got a ton of value. If you did and you need a little help, feel free to swing by our website or drop comments below. Of course, if you did get value, do give us that thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. But most importantly, my friend, keep on building.